What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to make an ARK server with Apex hosting. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. ARK Survival Evolved is definitely one of those games that is better with other people, with conquering dinosaurs and the world leading into crazy gameplay. That being said, it might be hard to really set up or keep a community without a dedicated server, since in order to play otherwise, the owner has to be online in order for other players to join. This is all easily fixed by having your own server, since it can be active 24/7 and anyone can join at any time. Having a server also opens up a whole slew of customizable features that you might not get in the regular game. Today, let's go over how to set up your own Apex server and some ways to configure it. Head into your Apex server panel and stop the server if it's currently running another game. Scroll down to see the game file option and then click on the current server version and look up ARK Survival Evolved. Confirm the changes and follow the prompts to generate a new world, and then you can restart the server afterwards. Wait for the server to load everything, which might take a few minutes, especially doing it the first time. Once it's done, you'll see a check near the top of the panel and it will say online. ARK is a pretty big game, which means it comes with a lot of different customizable and configurable options. Before we get into how to change those, let's first go over how you're going to join your new ARK server. On your Apex panel, find and copy the Steam IP and address port numbers, and then open Steam and press View in the top left, and select Servers. Afterwards, continue to the Favorites tab, and then click Add a Server in the bottom right. Enter your server's IP, address, and port, and then press Add this address to Favorites. After that is added, launch ARK and then select Join ARK from the menu. Change the session filter at the bottom to Favorites, which will then pull up the server that you put into Steam. And once you do see the server, click on it and continue to join near the bottom, and you'll start the game. For your first and arguably the most important configuration, you'll probably want to set a password on your server. To do this, first head into your server panel and stop the server, and then head to the left-hand side and find Customizations and click on it. Find and enter anything into the Server Password field. From that same Customizations page, you'll also set an admin password. Head to the Admin Password field in the Security category, and then change the password to anything that you want. And after making both of these changes, they will automatically save, and you can click on your username at the top, sending you back to the main panel where you can restart the server to lock in those changes. After setting that admin password, to set yourself as an admin, you'll want to join the server and then press Tab on your keyboard. Enter the command Enable Cheats and then your admin password. After this, you can use Cheat Fly or Cheat Walk to confirm that you have new admin powers. Another thing you can do from the Customization tab is set up a whitelist so that only certain players can join. Look for the Server Settings section option and then find Server Whitelist. Checkmark this setting and then head back to the main panel like before and restart the server. Once it loads, stop the server again and then head into the config files on the left and click on the ARK Whitelist file option and then keep this tab open for later. In another tab, you're going to want to head to the Steam IO website and search your username, along with any others that you want to whitelist. Copy the Steam ID 64 value and then return to the ARK whitelist file that you just had opened. Paste every account ID on a new blank line in the file, and afterwards press Save in the top left and restart the server one more time to apply the changes. The main benefit to hosting ARK servers is being able to completely control its settings. By default, the server files don't generate every option to edit, But if you're interested in editing or adding more settings to the panel, then I recommend looking through the ARK Server Configuration Wiki page for more info to get you started. To change some of these settings, head towards your Apex Server panel and stop the server. Click Config Files on the left-hand side, and then select the Server Configuration option, which you'll see is the Game User Settings file. On this page is where you'll be able to change certain values or add settings that might not already be in the file. Make note that you do not want to change anything here that's available in the Customizations tab, for example, like the server password. After editing this file the way that you want to, press Save in the top left, and after that, you can restart the server. You can also do things like add custom maps and install certain mods to completely change the way the game is played, whether that's how it looks or by adding new elements that aren't in the original. Doing both of these things are a little bit more of a process than changing your server settings, so we won't go over them today. But if you're interested in learning how to do these things, we have tutorials to both that will be linked down below. Creating and playing on an ARK server gives you and other players the chance to play at any time with no restraints. Whether you install maps and mods, or simply tweak server settings, the control is yours to hold. Learning exactly how everything works might take a few tries, but as you learn and experiment, it should become easier to manage. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.